how valuable it actually is. So here we go, going into the real game two. We have to the southwest end of the map, we have BagelDenizen versus his opponent, Deadbones, to the north end in green. And this map is interesting. It's actually fairly similar to the last one. Kind of. There's that high ground near Bagel's base with a windmill on it that's quite hard to get to, but then he has that expansion right in front of him, which is very tasty. And Deadbones does the same thing. This entire east end of the map is completely out of it. That's interesting. What do you think of the map? You can
get to the east part of the map, but it's very difficult. And there's no mills over there, so there's no point in going over there anyway. All the mills are on this west side. So this is actually interesting. Half the map has been cut off, which means there's a lot fewer places to maneuver. So we'll see if BagelDenizen with those lizards is at a disadvantage. Because lizards generally do better when you have more space to maneuver. Nice wide open fields to try and pick off farms. But in this case, there's about two ways to go. You can go straight down the center, or you can go to the west. And a lot of the fighting is going to be in the west here, over those mills. So we'll see.
I don't think that's going to be too much of a hindrance to him, actually. He's got a fairly versatile little build set there with all those units. I think he can just switch out, just only produce the squirrels, like how he was planning the other game. I think that could work out fairly well for him. He needs to take that forward expansion at some point. Just because Deadbones went for the expansion before Bagel in that first game and did completely overpower him in there. Going for that early wolf didn't really pay off. I'll be interested to see what he tries to do this game.
Alright, well here we go. Both players going for 7 farm warrens into squirrels. Again, this patch favors squirrels, just like May Mayhem. We've had a couple players varying up the meta, but we'll see how things progress through these quarterfinals. Both players going for pigeons after their squirrels. Neither player getting an expansion quite yet. I'm interested to see that, because BagelDenizen will put down a ferret warren fairly soon, if I'm not mistaken, if he keeps going for that. I would call it an early ferret warren. There it goes, right there.
Yeah, but this game, Deadbones has gone for the early ferret warren. He put one earlier than Bagel. Bagel's done one just now, but Deadbones is finished already, and he's already building his first ferret. So that's interesting, very interesting. Ferrets could be quite strong on this map. There's no way to flank them at all. You'd have to come straight at the army, which I think plays well into the squirrel ball kind of idea. You just want the enemy to force themselves into you because you will win the direct engagements with that raw DPS that you really get from the squirrel balls.
Taking a look at the army value graph here, Deadbones has pulled a little bit ahead, again probably because of those tier 2s that he got out slightly earlier. In terms of military structures, both players are pretty even. Economic, both players again are fairly even. But we see Deadbones spending his food a little bit more efficiently than BagelDenizen. Here we go, Deadbones taking his ferrets, poking away at some squirrels. Again, in this early game, taking out a couple squirrels before the first engagement is a good idea.
He's got that ferret paid off. That's 80 food worth of squirrels killed while Bagel was just doing something elsewhere on that little base that he has to the south end of the map. He was building that. So that's a pretty good start for Deadbones here.
Right, picking off 2 pigeons, not too much of an economic downturn, but again, in armies this equal, that might make the difference here. Pigeons will come back fairly soon, they're a tier 1 unit. But Deadbones, in the meantime, has taken the base, is much easier for him. He's his only base to expand to, but BagelDenizen has to kind of run back through his base to put farms down, whereas Deadbones, his placing his farms is kind of on the route that he needs to go to reach his opponent anyway, so Deadbones slightly more advantage with his base here. Bagel isn't throwing down the wolf, though. Again, 2 base wolf. He has expanded. He does have 3 farms down in his expansion. Deadbones.
Yep, I think that's a pretty good plan. Yep. Once he builds up a few more squirrels, that's just going to be truly devastating. He's going up to 18 right now. I wouldn't be surprised if he builds even more warrens. And even with a small amount of warrens, that wolf buff can really just do a massive amount of work. And he's taking a third expansion, he's taking that forward one. I'll be interested to see if he's using that just for a defensive position, or if he was going to build an economy on that, but he decides to sell it. And here's a fight right now.
Alright, Ferret's taking shots from the background. Looks like a lot of BagelDenizen and squirrels came away from that curtain. Sniper Balloon is out, and it is going to get up in time, so Deadbones taking some control of that middle there. His squirrels pushing BagelDenizen's army back. BagelDenizen forced to sell that expansion again. Again, we have passed that 5-minute mark, so the first 4 farms on each player's base have been farmed out. They will no longer produce food. Deadbones smartly getting back here to scout a little bit, and he'll dig back to his own base. It only takes a couple seconds.
That's a really bad situation for Bagel now. Now that he's lost that forward position, he has no real map presence, and he hasn't got the expansion fully up and running like Deadbones has. He's got 7 farms running on his expansion, Deadbones has, but Bagel only had 3 on that entire time. So now he's down to 7 farms.
And Deadbones throwing
really
down some artillery. See if it gets up in time. It's about half done here. Bagel has seen it, though, and wants to get in there before it started. The wolf is down. The wolf buff goes out, and squirrels are melting left and right. Deadbones sells that artillery. He's forced to sell it. That sniper balloon looks like it's also going to go down, but not before it takes out its fair share of squirrels. That wolf is still alive, but it's going down very quickly. Save that wolf, BagelDenizen. 4 health. 3 health. Gone. So the wolf is down. Unfortunately, Bagel couldn't sell it, and Deadbones' reinforcements come back in. You can see here Deadbones was very far down, but Bagel stayed perhaps a little bit too long.
That was a really good wolf attack, actually. He got the sniper balloon, he took out a majority of Deadbones' army, but he just got way too greedy there. He could have easily pulled out, just waited for his mostly tier 1 army to reinforce, which would have been fairly quick, and then just gone on the offensive again. But now he has to wait for that wolf, which he doesn't even have the food to produce. This is a really bad situation for Bagel here. Deadbones with a very strong economic situation here. Yeah, actually, now that all his original bases have died, he's actually the same as Bagel coming up here.
Yeah, Deadbones has had those farms out for longer, though, so he is ahead in terms of economy, and he's building those last two. Putting on that artillery, and the artillery does get out, and it's accompanied by a sniper balloon, so it can see everywhere the sniper balloon can see, which means BagelDenizen is now locked into this corner. Unless he can sneak out to the left and take that west base, which Deadbones has just taken. Here we go.
I don't think he can, though. Oh, those artillery shots!
Massive, taking down tons of squirrels, and Deadbones is going to push in right now. He knows he has the army advantage, and now is a great time to push in. He has economic advantage. Going to pull out a little bit, perhaps deciding now is not quite the time. But Bagel is now very scared of that artillery. There we go, he's baited that shot there. We'll see if he can sneak around.
Yeah, he can't actually get to that other position, not only because of Deadbones' Wimble there, but also because those trees are in the way. He has to go into the line of fire to even get there. It's just out of the situation. He just can't do that at all.
Oh yeah, you're right. Deadbones already with 4 farms down on that expansion, so juicier target, but again, there's not really any way for Bagel to get out of his base. I thought there was a pathway between those trees, but it looks like on the minimap there is no pathway through those trees without running through artillery. Here we go, Bagel trying to sneak around the side, though. We'll see if it works. He's just barely out of the range.
Oh no.
And all of the squirrels get taken out with just 2 shots, and the rest of the army scythed in half. Deadbones just absolutely eliminating BagelDenizen's army, and now he's free to go in and take as much damage as he wants. The pigeons leading the charge here. Warren after Warren's gonna fall right now. The wolf is out. The wolf buff does go down, but there's just too few units here to make a difference here. The wolf standing his ground to the last goes down.
You can really see why Deadbones likes to take those artilleries now. That was a really strong play there. Something that just a sniper balloon couldn't have actually managed. Holding that position, that was really strong. So Deadbones takes game 2.
All right, the score is now 2